Yo, I had to do this. I had to do this. Okay, so on my Instagram, right? I have like two brothers that I don't see them like at all anymore. Like one is 'cause he got licked out on crack. Another one is 'cause like there's only so many lines you could cross, and then it's like you know what I'm saying? I hope the best, but like man, I'm out. No matter how long that shit, been going on for, man, it's only like, and then you be moving grimy with other people. It is what it is. You know what I'm saying? Like my parents helped the motherfucker out enough. Like I ain't gonna get all into it, put his business out there like that, right? But anyway, like when we me and this kid that I'm about to show y'all, right? We was boys. It's like we was in like fifth or sixth grade, all the way up till we was like 20. I said like fuck you, I ain't fuck with you no more. Like when I was like 22 or 23, I was not fucking with this kid no more. 'Cause like bro, I could only help you so much. You asking shit I wasn't even asking my own parents for from my parents, because we was helping you out. You see what I'm saying? It's just crazy to me because when we first got to be chill, right? Like growing up, I did a lot of martial arts because like it was one of the only things that like me and my pops sort of like could see eye to eye on. Like me and my pops did not get along for a very long time. Like I was like, I don't even know why. Like really, like I get it. Like he's kind of hard to deal with, but at the same time, it's like I was going OD for no reason. Like it was beyond my control for the longest time. I'm not gonna lie, but I was never like wildin', but like yeah, like she gets hard and shit. But I just, that's why I love my adopted parents, 'cause them motherfuckers like they didn't have to like keep me around like that, but they did, you know. So, but yeah, like so what I'm about to show, when we first got to be like cool, like I was in martial arts and like I had some belts and whatnot, and I was doing a few different things. You know what I'm saying? I started with jujitsu when I was way little, traditional Japanese jujitsu, and then I went on to doing taekwondo and wrestling, and I did a whole bunch of shit. And I was fighting since I was, yeah. Then I started doing, oh yeah, I did Muay Thai as well. So I was always really good with my hands. You know what I'm saying? And eventually, I started dabbling Brazilian jiu-jitsu. I got the gist of it. Didn't, you know what I'm saying, follow it all the way through, but you know what I'm saying? I did enough to where like this kid had gone with me to like a couple of my classes. You see what I'm saying? Like he had been like watching me doing this shit growing up. So like it's kind of funny of me watching this, because as someone who's done some jobber type shit and like some unranked, seasons, it's kind of like I know the statistics enough. Plus, like my parents' neighbor, she was a booker for Strikeforce. I know sort of what the statistics is. If you're like, if UFC is your goal and you're a white belt at 30, I'm not gonna say anything further than that. But it's shit. Does, shit takes time, bro. Like I know some belts like judo and Brazilian jiu-jitsu take a lot longer than others. Same with regular jiu-jitsu take like taekwondo. That's probably like one of the quickest belts I got that shit in like 3 years. You see what I'm saying? So it's like there's some that's like mad quick, and then there's some that's long as hell. So it's like if you really want to be versed like that, like I give him this. Like he got some form to him. I'll give him, he got some form to him, but your body's starting to break down. Like I know this about myself. You see what I'm saying? So, but I figured, why not? This came to me. I'm never gonna talk to this kid in person again. You know what I'm saying? But it's someone that sort of had a big chapter in my life. You know what I'm saying? I hope his mom's doing well. I hope his brother's doing well. I hope he's doing well. I just don't fuck with him. When people refer to you sometimes as cancer, that's not good. And they're not talking about a zodiac sign. All right, so check this out.
People often ask me why I pay to get punched or to get kicked or kneed or slammed or destroyed by professionals.
Pause. This kid was hella dramatic all the time. I'm not gonna fucking lie. Hella dramatic. Hella dramatic. Me and this kid used to do backyard wrestling together. Like,
He's good at this shit. I'm not gonna lie, he's good at this shit. Like, he really should have been, like, a pro wrestler. He really should have been. He should have started doing some jobber matches, some fill-in matches. You know what I'm saying? That's some shit you can get into at 30. I'm not gonna lie. I mean, you're not gonna make much money at all. It's probably gonna be about the same you'd make doing little, like, you know, indie promotions for MMA. And then with those, a lot of times, it's only winner's purses. You don't get... If you lose, usually, a lot of times. And a lot of times, too, it's like you have to pay to qualify and shit like that. There's a lot of, it's not all the time, obviously, but depending on where you're at, what, you know, promotion you're working with, who's the promoter. Like, there's one dude out in Denver who, like, he does all that shit. So it's like, it made it sort of easier because you knew. It was one guy. It wasn't like you had to chase down this dude, this dude, this dude. As far as promotion went, in terms of all levels, it was like one dude till you got to, like I said, then there was the people you didn't see. Like my parents' neighbor who worked as a booker at Strikeforce, who I only know because she was real close friends with my mom. I remember she was like, she was telling me how she met Jake Shields one time. Like, I think it was right after or right before the Mayhem fight, one of them, but... Yeah, so anyway, we're going to keep rolling this. So it's my strange little brother, Kev. If I could find something of my strange little brother, Trell, I might put that up there. But, I mean, I try to sort of, like, protect him a little bit. Because, like, Trell is sad. Like, it's sad. That's my little brother. Like, I love that kid to death. But it is what it is. You know, to come a point where it's like, I got to step back. You know what I'm saying? So.
Truth is this is what I love. This is what I like. This is what makes me feel good. This is what my dream is. This is what I've always wanted to do.
The George Costanza-looking dude on the left, in the blue shirt, the balding guy.
Unfortunately, I didn't get to start this a little earlier. I wish I did. But you know what? Time's ticking.
Look at how the guard drops every time. Your whole shit's open. Whole shit's open. And you starting to jackhammer. You'll get it. I just know you knowing you probably going to be like, fuck this before you do, but...
It's now or never. I don't care if you're 30, 40, 35, 50, whatever the hell age you are, go out and do what you need to do now, because life is short. If you don't eat, sleep, and shit your dreams, you will never succeed. So go out, wake up, and get done what needs to get done.
I really got a lot of creativity with the man. I really, he made himself a gif. He made himself a gif doing roundhouse kicks on a heavy bag. That's lit.